It was a time of celebration. The defeat of Scar had been long ago, and the Pridelands were happily at peace. Carried on the crest of the wind was a message from Mufasa that had gathered all the animals around Pride Rock like a father's gentle arm. The royal family, King Simba and Queen Nala, the majordomo Zazu, the wise one Rafiki, and the family friends Pumbaa and Timon stood high on the summit. When Rafiki walked to the edge, he was carrying Simba and Nala's firstborn cub. He lifted the small bundle to the heavens, then he extended it to the jubilant animals below. A new circle of life had begun. Timon nudged Pumbaa affectionately.
Ah, Pumbaa, look at that little guy. A chip off the old block. And you gotta know who's gonna raise him. I'm telling you, buddy, it's gonna be like old times. You, me, and the little guy.
It is a girl.
Girl!
The two friends fainted dead away. Baby Kiara's early years passed rapidly, and soon she was old enough to be on her own. One morning, she burst out of the lion's cave to go exploring. Simba was fast on her heels with some fatherly advice.
Kiara, are you listening? Accidents can happen. You could easily get hurt or
stepped on, or even get lost.
And stay away from the Outlands.
Zazu flew overhead.
Nothing there but a bunch of backstabbing, murderous outsiders.
Zazu's right. You can't turn your back on them.
Really? How come?
Never mind. Just run along now.
As Nala scampered off into a field of tall grass, Simba summoned Pumbaa and Timon to his side.
I want you to keep a close watch on Kiara. Do you know she's bound to run off?
Don't worry, Simba. We're on her like stink on a warthog.
Hey!
It's a hard truth, Pumbaa. Live with it.
Guys, I'm counting on you. Danger could be lurking behind every rock.
Kiara continued through the grass and down over some rocks, unaware that she was being shadowed by her two friends. By and by, she came to a swampy river that looked difficult to cross. Climbing over a fallen log, she lost her balance. But it wasn't the murky water that she made contact with. It was another lion cub.
Who are you, Pridelander?
This new young lion stepped forward, and Kiara took a step back. The stranger took another step forward, and Kiara took another step back. Then he turned to his right, so she turned to her left.
What are you doing?
My father says to never turn your back on an outsider.
You always do what Daddy says?
No, bet you do. Bet your daddy's little girl.
The conceited young cub, whose name was Kovu, leaped to another log.
An outsider doesn't need anybody. I take care of myself.
Really? Cool.
Kiara leaped after him. She wanted to learn more about this cat. But just then, one of the fallen logs moved. It wasn't a log at all. It was a crocodile. And its huge mouth was opening for Kiara. The cub scrambled onto some rocks. The crocodile came after them. The lions looked wildly around.
This way!
There was a small island in the middle of the river. Kovu and Kiara took a giant leap across the water and landed safely on it.
That was a close one.
Yeah.
But then the whole island began to move, and it turned out to be a tangled knot of sleeping crocodiles. Suddenly, the cubs were being lifted into the air on the back of a huge tail. Kovu dived into the water and dog paddled as fast as he could. But one crocodile was right on his tail. He was about to take a bite when Kiara jumped on his head, closing its mouth shut. Kovu swam to shore and Kiara jumped across. The cub stood on the riverbank, panting, looking down at the crocodiles. When Kiara finally caught her breath, she felt victorious.
I did it! I did it! Oh, man! Did you see the size of those teeth? They were going, rah, 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 rah. He just totally ate me up right there. I jumped on his head, and I popped him so good. We make such a good team. And you... really brave.
Kiara strutted away, ready to take on the world. Now it was Kovu who followed Kiara.
Yeah, you are pretty brave too. My name's Kovu.
I'm Kiara.
At that moment, the young lions felt as if there weren't anyone else in the world. Little did they know that when Kiara said her name, another lioness, huddled in the tall grass, had pricked up her ears and hunched down even lower. Kiara playfully poked Kovu and bounded away, ready to be chased. But Kovu sat motionless, his face a blank. So Kiara tried something else. She crouched in the grass and wiggled her hind end as though she were going to pounce. Kovu understood this immediately. A huge grin wiped across his face. He assumed the same position, and the two lions sprang at each other, growling playfully. Then suddenly, Simba was on the scene, and he got between the two cubs. In the next instant, the lioness sprang out of the grass, and she blocked Kovu. Simba recognized her.
Zira.
Simba. Timon. Pumbaa. Great, now that we all know each other. Get out of our pride lands!
Your pride lands? These lands belong to Scar.
I banished you from the pride lands. Now you and your young cub, get out.
Oh, haven't you met my son, Kovu? He was hand-chosen by Scar to follow in his paw prints and become king. Kovu was the last born before you exiled us to the Outlands, where we have little food, less water.
You know the penalty for returning to the Pride Lands.
But the child does not. However, if you need your pound of flesh, here.
Zira, the mother lioness, scooped up her young son and offered him to Simba. Kovu trembled, looking wide-eyed into Simba's soul. Would this lion king hurt him? But Simba turned his smoldering gaze back on Zira.
Take him and get out. We're finished here.
Oh, no, Simba. We have barely begun.
She leered menacingly at Kiara, her son dangling from her mouth. As the two enemies turned to go their separate ways, Kiara locked eyes with Kovu. Their friendship was only just beginning. On the long journey back to Pride Rock, Simba let the others get ahead so that he could have a quiet talk with Kiara. He sat her down on a rock.
Kiara, what did you think you were doing? You could have been killed today.
But, Daddy, I didn't mean to disobey.
I'm telling you this because I love you. I don't want to lose you.
I know.
If something happened to you, I don't know what I'd do. One day I won't be here. And I need you to carry on in my place. You are part of the great circle of...
Circle of life, I know.
Exactly. And you need to be careful. As future queen...
What if I don't want to be queen? It's no fun.
That's like saying you don't want to be a lion. It's in your blood, as I am. We are part of each other. As long as you live here, it's who you are. You'll understand someday.
As you go through life, you'll see there is so much that we don't understand. And the only thing we